And good evening, everyone. I am thrilled to welcome you to Outstanding 2020. Words truly cannot express how happy I am that I can welcome you to a celebration tonight. An evening where we can share the sweetness of relief and hope for a better tomorrow. Now, if we were in person, I know that you all would be cheering and clapping. So please feel free to do so wherever you are. These are days when we need to seize every moment we can celebrate. Of course, we know that tremendous work lies ahead, and this year has been exhausting. And yet, in the midst of all the new challenges, all the new demands upon you, you never stepped away from your commitment to Keshet and our work for full LGBTQ equality in Jewish life. Thank you. Thank you for sticking with us. Your support was a shining burst of light this year. I want to share with you three other glimmers of light. First, in the face of this administration's relentless assaults on LGBTQ civil rights, we saw rabbis and other Jewish community leaders take action for equality, many of them for the first time. Rabbis in particular were eager to speak out against the abuse of so-called religious freedom to justify bigotry towards LGBTQ people. Rabbi Lauren Grable Herman, a Keshet leader and the rabbi of SAJ, Judaism that stands for all, told me, "Our Jewish tradition teaches that everyone is created B'Tselem Elohim, in the image of the divine. Every person has the right to be treated with respect. And as rabbis, it is up to us to express this as a religious obligation. It is up to us to demand that everyone is treated with dignity. This is what you are making possible." Second, as many of you know, before the pandemic, Keshet hosted LGBTQ Jewish teen Shabbatonim, which are weekend retreats. These gatherings are often life-changing for queer Jewish teens. Because of COVID, of course, we had to cancel our Shabbatonim this year, but we reinvented our youth work by hosting weekly free online gatherings. These programs have been incredibly popular, and for many teens, they are a vital lifeline. We all have experienced the isolation of living through COVID. We continue to do so. Imagine the loneliness of a queer teen who isn't out, or who is out, but isn't supported by their family. We have kids who are literally taking their laptops into their childhood bedroom closets, putting earbuds in, and whispering, hoping that no one hears them. Jay, a trans teen who's come to many of our online gatherings, told us, "Being in a virtual setting where I can be validated with my name and pronouns has been so important for me and others, especially for those of us who are still closeted and aren't affirmed at home or in school. This is what you are making possible." Third, in mid-March, when everyone began sheltering in place, Keshet had 37 trainings scheduled through the end of April for staff and lay leaders at synagogues, JCCs, day schools, and other Jewish institutions. All but two of those institutions told us they needed to press pause on their work for LGBTQ equality because they needed to focus on their core work. On the one hand, we understood that everyone was moving into emergency mode. On the other hand, it concerned us that so many institutions were viewing work for LGBTQ equality as secondary, not as a necessity. Suddenly, many Jewish communities were reverting back to what my friend April Baskin calls their factory settings, the way they've always done things, which of course leaves a lot of people out, including queer folks. So we at Keshet did what community organizers do. We stayed in conversation. We asked staff and lay leaders at Jewish institutions, what does it mean that working for LGBTQ equality isn't part of your core work now? Who is the we who decides what work is essential? And if LGBTQ people are left out of decisions and conversations during COVID, what does that mean for what your community will look like and feel like when the pandemic is over? I'm pleased to share with you that as of June, we started to see a surge of interest in working with Keshet. When we opened registration for our first ever online leadership project, which is a year-long program of training and consultation, our enrollment filled up in less than 48 hours, and we have 8 synagogues on the wait list. Seth Gorin, Chief Education and Campus Officer at Hillel, Ontario, told us that Keshet's training gave his staff the skills to increase their LGBTQ programming during this time and to better support students who were home without family support. We're not yet seeing a full reset of those factory settings, but what we are seeing is a growing awareness that the old ways of doing work are not serving us all. They never have. And that it's time, it's way past time, to do things differently. This is what you are making possible. I want to close by noting where we were 4 years ago and where we are today. A little over 4 years ago, 2 days after the 2016 election, I got an email from Aaron Schreiber, a Hillel director at a college outside of St. Louis. Aaron wrote me that early that morning, she had gotten a text from a transgender student who was panicked, who was absolutely in a crisis. He talked about feeling terrified about what the next 4 years held for him. So Aaron said, "I'll meet you at the Hillel office in a half hour," and she dashed off to her car. Only once she was on her way did she suddenly think to herself, "Oh no, what did I just do? I'm a mess. I'm completely in shock. How can I possibly be there for someone else?" So she walked into the Hillel building, still not knowing what she would say. And she opened the door to her office and nearly stepped on an envelope that was stuck underneath it. She opened the envelope, and inside, she found the Keshet LGBTQ Safe Zone stickers she had asked us for the previous week. Her student walked into the room, and she held the sticker in front of him. And she said, "Look, there is hope. We have a whole community that is standing with us." Over the past 4 years, I've often imagined a day when that student will look back on November 9th, 2016 and think to himself, "On that terrible morning, when I felt so much fear for my future, I sought support from my Jewish community and I found it." But I've also thought about the many students and others who haven't been as lucky. Over the past 4 years, we've heard from numerous day school and Hebrew school teachers, from JCC staff and others, that they were asked by their heads of school or senior rabbis or CEOs to remove their LGBTQ Safe Zone stickers. Why? They were told the stickers are partisan. They were told that the sticker might offend community members who support the current administration. Which brings us to the fall of 2020. When a Keshet teen leader, Rivka Schafer, a 15-year-old student at the Idea School, a modern Orthodox high school in Teaneck, New Jersey, approached one of their teachers to talk to him about putting up an LGBTQ Safe Zone sticker. Rivka never thought that ultimately he would agree, but he did. And he put it right by the sign for the school's Beit Midrash, the Tech Study Center. Rivka tells me that some students have been taking the sticker down or covering it up, but Rivka keeps putting it back. And Rivka knows that their Keshet community stands with them every step of the way. Whether we're in a moment of crisis, ongoing struggle, or a time of hope and optimism, Keshet is able to meet the moment with the perseverance we need to keep building the world as it should be. And we couldn't do it without you. I could tell you more about how your support has made an impact on people's lives and communities nationwide. But right now, I want to welcome to join us Rivka Schafer, so you can hear from them directly. As I mentioned, Rivka is 15. They're a student at the Idea School in Teaneck, New Jersey. They're a member of the school's theater club and environmental club. They're a youth group leader at their local synagogue. They served on the steering committee of the Keshet Midwest Shabbaton and now co-lead a Keshet Monday night hangout for queer Jewish teens. I am delighted for Rivka Schafer to join us now. Thank you, Rivka.
Thank you for having me. I come from the Orthodox community, so I don't have very many queer friends. And when I came out in my Orthodox middle school in eighth grade, I was immediately branded as an outcast. I was really struggling with my Jewish and queer identity because they seemed to be in conflict. After the trauma from what happened in middle school, I was on the path of giving up my Jewish identity when I went to the Keshet East Coast Shabbaton. And everything changed. All of a sudden, I knew a ton of other queer people who were also Jewish. I now had so many friends that I could reach out to when I needed support. All of a sudden, I had found a place that accepted every part of me. One of my favorite memories from the Shabbaton took place one night after programming, when a bunch of us were hanging out in my room, singing songs and strumming a guitar. I felt such a strong feeling of community and belonging. I felt like I had finally found a home. But the biggest thing that Keshet did for me was that it showed me I could be both queer and Jewish, that I can value and cherish both. That changed my life. All of a sudden, I could envision a life for myself where I stayed in the Jewish community and got a wife. Before, it was always one or the other. Keshet showed me that these two things didn't have to be in contradiction. And then the pandemic hit. Because of quarantine and social distancing, I started to feel very isolated. It's easy to feel lonely when you're not able to see and hug your friends. But Keshet started online programming, and that gave me a chance to connect with other queer Jewish teens on a weekly basis. I'm actually now interacting with other queer Jewish teens more regularly than before the pandemic. Having the chance to positively engage with people online has been super valuable to me. Keshet gave me a space where I can talk with people, laugh, and feel good, and it makes a world of difference for my mental health. Keshet also helped me to give back to the community. I met my friend Iz at the East Coast Shabbaton that was made possible by supporters like you. And together we launched a peer support program called Monday Night Hangouts, which is a safe space for teens to connect, share their ongoing struggles, and find support among friends who understand. It's been so rewarding for me to be able to help other people. Keshet changed my life, and I'm so happy that I'm able to help change other people's lives. I'm really grateful for all these spaces where I can just be myself. Now, because of Keshet, I have lots of other queer Jewish friends, and I now know that I can be happy with every part of me.